Western Sydney is shaping up as a big winner from the federal budget, with $300 million going into roads, including money for a connection from the M7 near Blacktown past Richmond. The $1 billion infrastructure spend will also include money for high-speed rail plans, but there's nothing for Warragamba Dam.
A bird's-eye view of a flood-hit town. The Prime Minister surveys the damage and emergency plan for Victoria, while his government maps out plans for the country.
What you'll have is straight commitments, straight delivery, real funding for real projects.
Today, confirming this month's federal budget will include $9.6 billion for roads and rail projects across Australia, with Victoria getting the most, at more than $2.5 billion, closely followed by the Northern Territory, Queensland and then New South Wales. There's nearly $700 million each for Tasmania, Western Australia and South Australia.
These are the election commitments that we took, obviously, to the last election.
But since the last election, inflation has soared, prompting the Treasurer to issue this warning just days ago.
We're not spraying money around because that would be counterproductive when it comes to our inflation challenge.
The government insists this isn't a cash spray, claiming most of the money will be reshuffled.
There is an additional spend, but it's modest. We're very confident that that will not add to inflation.
Economists say it'll all come down to when the work begins.
What we're going to be doing is just adding some additional pressure to that economy if we don't get the timing of these projects right.
As for who will be available to do the work in the already stretched construction industry,
it's going to probably continue to mean that workers building houses get lured away into these major infrastructure projects because they often get paid more.
The budget will be handed down here in Canberra in 9 days' time, and Labor has indicated that some of the previous coalition government's infrastructure spending could end up on the chopping block, including a regional deal done between the Liberals and Nationals.
The Labor government has a track record of ignoring the regions.
The test for us is there a business case? Does it stack up?
Fiona Whillen, Nine News.
But not everyone is happy with the big spend. The New South Wales government tonight hitting out. State politics reporter Liz Daniels joins us from Macquarie Street. And Liz, the Treasurer says we're being shortchanged.
That's right, Georgie. Matt Keane has hit out at the federal government saying that New South Wales is being dutted of its fair share. $1 billion has been set aside for projects in this state, including high-speed rail connections to Newcastle and road upgrades in Western Sydney, but that's less than half of what's been handed to the Victorians, and it has the state government crying poor. Georgie, it was hoping for cash to help build up the Warragamba Dam wall.